I'm cutting to the chase with this one. It takes 8 beard essentials to get my beard to look like this. And in today's video, we're going through each of them. First things first, the beard trimmer. Even if you don't know how to use one of these, you still have to have one. It only takes a few trims for you to get the basics. Now with the trimmer, you can maintain your beard on your own. Even if it's not at that barber level, you're still maintaining that cleanliness. You're still keeping it in shape and it just looks good week to week. So that's a win. As of right now, I'm using the Philips Series 3000 trimmer. It comes with a guard and it works wonders. Second essential would be the Chevette razor. Now, I know it'd be a little daunting to use this for the first time. I've cut myself numerous times even today, but it just takes practice. Now, this allows me to get that crisp lineup whenever I need it, so that saves me another trip to the barber. Now, here's the thing. I know some of you guys might have those Fusion Gillette razors, like the 4-blade one. Those ones, they don't have the accuracy that the Chevette single-blade razor does. Next up, we have the Beard Growth Kit. This kit from Copenhagen Grooming, who is also sponsoring this video, includes a beard derma roller, or the beard roller, an activating serum, a cleansing agent for the roller, and a cute little comb. Now I use this on areas of my beard that are a little patchy, typically on my upper cheek area. First things first, I cleanse the entire head of the roller, and then I roll 10 times vertically, horizontally, and diagonally on the thinning area. I do this every third day. Then I apply the activator serum, which activates the dormant hair follicles. Now I use this one every day. Now the combination of the beard roller and the activator serum is a great way to activate those dormant hair follicles underneath the skin. If you're someone who's trying to grow a beard and you don't have the means to go to Turkey and get a hair transplant, it's 2023 and this is the next best thing, I'm telling you. Now you can use my code BUGZT20 to get 20% off your order. Follow the link in the description box down below. Alright, now next on the beard essential list would be the beard comb as well as the beard brush. Now you may be wondering, what's the difference? This bristle brush is used for shaping as well as patting down the beard. I find it's best used to pat down those stray hairs after a shower. Now it's important to note that you can't actually use a regular brush because the bristles on that brush are too spread out and it just doesn't work. Trust me, I've tried. Doesn't work. Now for the comb, I typically use this to define certain aspects of my beard. For example, my chin. I comb my chin to lengthen the goatee, essentially giving me a longer face. Okay, next up, this one's a must, beard washes. Whenever I'm hopping in the shower, and I hope you are too, I'm washing my beard. There's a lot of gunk that's in there. But it's important to note that I'm not just using any bar soap, you know? You gotta use a soap that is geared for your beard. I'm using Copenhagen Grooming's 8 AM Splash, which is designed to keep your beard's natural oils as well as clean it. Just keep this thing clean, please. This brings me to beard exfoliation. Now, if there's one thing I know is guys are not exfoliating their skin, let alone the skin under their beards. Now, don't get me wrong, I understand. Especially when you have a beard that's a certain length, it's hard to exfoliate under there, which is why I use this exfoliating pad thing. Now the way this thing works is it has little rubber bristles on it, just like a brush, but they're more pointy, I guess. And you rub it right into the skin, right into the beard. I'm telling you guys, you have to try it. Like, it seriously gets right through the beard onto the skin, and your skin is a lot healthier under there. Just a quick note on that exfoliator. I know you guys might move past that one, just thinking, yeah, this guy's talking exfoliation, whatever. Trust me, I had to shave my entire beard off because the amount of dandruff under there was unreal. So instead of shaving the beard off and then exfoliating, just exfoliate under the beard. Please, trust me, do it, okay? Thanks. All right, next on the list, two words, my friends. Beard oil. Please. After you've cleansed your beard, it is dying to get that full nutrients back. That's why after every shower and after every soap up, I'm slapping some beard oil on there to keep it protected from the dry elements of the world. I've been using Copenhagen Grooming's beard oil, or the Beard Hero, for over a year and a half now. It works wonders. It seals the hair, protects it, and it smells great. What's not to love? And finally, last but not least, get yourself a beard balm. Now this is like the spice in the beard world. It acts as a shaping agent to your beard. So after I've oiled my beard, I'll get myself a beard balm, or in this case, the Cruise Control by Copenhagen Grooming. I'll get a dime's worth of that and I'll apply it straight to my beard, shaping it exactly how I want it. If I want that Hagrid action, boom, Hagrid. If I want to look like Bowser, done, Bowser. I typically go for the super swagalicious look, but that's your call. It's your preference. You do you, my friend. And that be it. That's 8 different beard essentials that I'm pretty much using on a daily or weekly basis. I want to thank Copenhagen Grooming for sponsoring this video. You can find all their information in the description box down below. Remember, you can use my code BUGZT20 to get 20% off your order. Check out Copenhagen Grooming's beard growth kit and their beard care products, and let me know what you guys think. Thanks again for watching. This is Bugs.